Greetings, brother. You raise a very common question, brother. Mark 10:18. Why do you call me good? Jesus answered. No one is good except God alone. How do you think Jesus would feel if we called him God? The answer is already recorded in the Bible, brother. So let's see how Jesus actually responded when men said such things to Jesus. Matthew 16:13. When Jesus came into the coasts of Caesarea Philippi, he asked his disciples, saying, Whom do men say that I, the Son of Man, am? And they said, Some say you are John the Baptist, some Elias, and others Jeremias, or one of the prophets. He said unto them, But whom say you that I am? And Simon Peter answered and said, You are the Christ, the Son of the living God. Notice what Peter said and did not say. Peter did not say, Well, like others, Jesus, we believe you are only a prophet. Peter also did not say, We believe you have come to announce Ahmad to come. Peter also did not say, We have no idea, but we're willing to waste our time following you because you hand out free bread. Peter said, You are the Christ, the Son of the living God. And Jesus heard what Peter said. And Jesus answered what Peter said. Now, before reading what Jesus actually said, let's list what Jesus did not say. Jesus did not say, Peter, you blaspheme. God has no son. Jesus did not say, Peter, God cannot beget. Jesus did not say, No, Peter, I am only a prophet, and I am not even the seal of the prophets. We know exactly what Jesus said, and it was none of these Quranaligned, misguided thoughts. And Jesus answered and said unto him, Blessed are you, Simon Barjona, for flesh and blood has not revealed it unto thee, but my Father which is in heaven. Essentially, Jesus said, Peter, you are correct. I am the Son of God. But there is no way you could know this, Peter, except that Almighty God, my Father in heaven, has revealed it to you. And Jesus answered and said unto him, Blessed are you, Simon Barjona, for flesh and blood has not revealed it unto you, but my Father, which is in heaven. So knowing that Jesus is the Son of God is something special from God. Evidently, being the Son of God is not the same as a Son of God. Why do you call me good? Jesus answered, No one is good except God alone. How do you think Jesus would feel if we called him God? The answer is already recorded in the Bible, brother. But let's look at another aspect which proves who Jesus is. God accepts worship. Genesis 24, And the man bowed down his head and worshipped the Lord Yahweh. And he said, Blessed be the Lord God, Yahweh Adonai, of my master Abraham, who has not left destitute my master of his mercy and his truth. I being in the way, the Lord led me to the house of my master's brethren. God accepts worship, but God does not allow worship of false gods. 2 Chronicles 7:22, And it shall be answered, because they forsook the Lord God of their fathers, which brought them forth out of the land of Egypt. And they laid hold on other gods, and worshipped them, and served them. Therefore has he brought all this evil upon them. Jeremiah 1:16, And I will utter my judgments against them, touching all their wickedness, who have forsaken me, and have burned incense into other gods, and worshipped the works of their own hands. You see, brother, God does not allow the worship of other than himself. Also, a prophet refuses worship. Even angels reject worship. Even Peter the Apostle rejected worship. Acts 10:25, and as Peter was coming in, Cornelius met him and fell down at his feet and worshipped him. But Peter took him up, saying, "Stand up, I myself also am a man." Peter stopped the worship. But when Jesus received worship, he did not make it stop. While he spake these things unto them, behold, there came a certain ruler and worshipped him, saying, "My daughter is even now dead, but come and lay your hand on her, and she shall live." Or Matthew 14:33, "Then they that were in the ship came and worshipped him, saying, Of a truth thou art the Son of God." Matthew 15:25, "Then came she and worshipped him, saying, Lord, help me. But he answered and said, It is not meet to take the children's bread and cast it to the dogs." In this last case, it was not even a Jewish woman who worshipped Jesus. And his response was not, "Don't worship me." So Jesus accepted worship even from a non-Jewish Canaanite woman. God accepts worship. Jesus accepts worship. So Jesus is God. But before you shake your head and stop thinking, brother, please meditate on this one fact. Jesus accepted worship and Jesus worked miracles. You would repeat the Quran's claim by Allah's permission. That means that Allah accepted Jesus being worshipped as Allah. Think it through, brother. The miracles were with Allah. Then Allah worked the miracles which deified Jesus. Did Allah not know that by working the miracles, Jesus would be deified? I'll leave that as a question and topic for another video, brother. So let's get back to the scripture you initially quoted, brother. No one is good except God alone. I'm sure you think this is a question which Christians cannot answer or face, because you think the only answer proves that Jesus is not God. But that is only because you only accept Islamic definitions and teaching, brother. We must respect the text and what Jesus said. "And when he was gone forth into the way, there came one running and kneeled to him and asked him, Good master, what shall I do that I may inherit eternal life?" The same story is repeated again in the Gospels. Matthew 19:16. "And behold, one came and said unto him, Good master, what good thing shall I do that I may have eternal life?" And again in Luke. "And a certain ruler asked him, saying, Good master, what shall I do to inherit eternal life?" Please notice that in all three records of this event, the man called Jesus Good Master and asked Jesus how to obtain eternal life. Remember, brother, Islam claims that Jesus was a prophet of Islam. And if that claim were true, Jesus could not have given a definitive answer, because Islam can only teach Allah saves whom he will and Allah condemns whom he will. A prophet of Islam would know this and have to say the very thing. This tells me Jesus was not teaching Muhammad's religion, which you call Islam. But let's examine how Jesus answered the man. Mark 10:18, "And Jesus said unto him, Why callest thou me good? There is none good but one, that is God." And in Matthew, "And he said unto him, Why do you call me good? Why callest thou me good? There is none good but one, that is God. But if you will enter into life, keep the commandments." And in Luke, "And Jesus said unto him, Why callest thou me good? None is good save one, that is God." Now, brother, I noticed one big difference between what you quoted and what I read. No one is good except God alone. In your quote, you say God alone. There are many translations of the Bible into English, and some do say the following. Why do you call me good? Jesus answered. No one is good except God alone. That's the NIV. The New Living. Why do you call me good? Jesus asked. Only God is truly good. The English Standard. And Jesus said unto him, Why do you call me good? No one is good except God alone. King James. And Jesus said unto him, Why callest thou me good? There is none good but one, that is God. Certainly the word alone appears in valid translations of this verse. And I think because of Islam's teachings, you see an extra is inserted. God is alone. But when read correctly, the words convey a meaning, only God is good. And even hearing those words, Islamic definitions confuse what that means, brother. The God of the prophets revealed himself as Echad, three united as one. To be perfectly clear, only God is good. But if you do not believe God's revelation of himself, you will not know who or what God is, brother. Getting back to your question, no one is good except God, or clarified, only God is good. How do you think Jesus would feel if we called him God? I think Jesus was asking an easily answered question, and the answer that would have been praised by Jesus is the following. Jesus, I call you good because you are the Son of God, Yahweh, the Most High. Jesus, I call you good because you are one with God the Father. Jesus, I call you good because you will be pierced, as Prophet Zechariah spoke of Yahweh in Zechariah 12:10. So Jesus, you are Yahweh who will be pierced by the children of Abraham. Jesus, I call you good because you are Yahweh come in the flesh. Jesus, I call you good because you are Yahweh announced by the voice in the wilderness, Prophet John. To which I would have expected Jesus to say, Flesh and blood has not revealed this to you, but my Father in heaven. The answer is clear when you know the message of the prophets, brother. Truly, no one is good but Yahweh, the God of heaven and earth. And the Lord Jesus is God and worthy to be called good. I know that differs from what Muhammad's religion has taught you, brother. Please ask any additional questions you have. The God of the true path has no fear of any question from someone in Islam. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.